Utah Jazz have been phenomenal this season. And honestly, it's kind of disrespectful. Damn, I had a little burp right there. But it's disrespectful of all hell that the media isn't talking about them. But specifically, they're not talking about Hassan Whiteside and Rudy Gay, arguably the two best free agent signings of this offseason. Now, I want to hear your thoughts down below if you're a Utah Jazz fan or if you're just an NBA fan. What do you guys think of the Utah Jazz, especially what do you think of Rudy Gay and Hassan Whiteside? Both of them have proven to be valuable players that have provided depth to this team and has addressed the epic need for better perimeter defense and has allowed, because they did get exposed in the playoffs last year, in a way that they're going to be able to fix that, I believe so, is by utilizing Rudy Gay in lineups with Royce O'Neal, Mike Conley, and Donovan Mitchell and Rudy Gobert, because that gives them a lot more length and size, okay? And Rudy Gay can also rebound and stretch the floor. I mean, tonight he had 20 plus points, okay? Hassan Whiteside had a double-double tonight, okay? They were cooking with gas, okay? Maybe even with kerosene, because they were lighting a fire. And that's one of the best things you can see with this team. And even Trent Forrest has shown value, okay? I don't even know what position you would say Trent Forrest plays. Trent Forrest, is he a wing? Okay? And he's a guy who's been on this team for a little bit, and he seems like, out of the young guys, he's the one who's kind of played the most out of my uni, Elijah Hughes, Jared Butler, and Udoka Azubuike. So one of the commentators, not commentators, but commenters, down below in the another video told me Udoka Azubuike, the reason he hasn't played is he's fragile. And that's sad to hear as a KU student. I go to the school of the University of Kansas. I'm right now visiting my folks back in Maryland in my mother's basement currently. And that's sad to hear if it's true. But Hassan Whiteside gives them a backup center that is legitimately a, almost, you could argue, a Kroger Walmart store brand, great value brand version of Rudy Gobert. Hassan Whiteside can do a pretty good job of imitating Rudy Gobert's play style, playing very efficient basketball, only shooting 5 feet within the basket, putbacks, rebounding, blocking shots, and basically contesting anything with their sheer size, because Hassan Whiteside is what, 7'1"? If last time I checked, he's a big boy, 7'1", 265, okay? Big man, and he's only 32. And honestly, his per 36 numbers are on par with his numbers when he was on the Trailblazers, okay? And you still have Jordan Clarkson and Jingling Joe Jingles, okay? And Joe Ingles, but I gave him a new nickname, Joe Jingles, because I thought that'd be funny. And I haven't talked about that in a while. You still got those guys, and, you know, you still have Mike Conley, Donovan Mitchell, Rudy Gobert, okay? Bogdan Bogdanovic, okay? I just said Bogdan Bogdanovic. I mean Bojan Bogdanovic, obviously, okay? Two different guys. Bojan's the older man. And Bojan, I know on the season, his three-point shot has been amazing, okay? He's been freaking amazing from three. And honestly, he's having a great year. This team's, I think, firing on all cylinders, and it's due to the part Rudy Gay and Hassan Whiteside have lessen the pressure on the starting lineup, and what that has allowed them to have a lot more success than they have had in years prior. So with that being said, I want to hear your thoughts down below. What do you guys expect from the Utah Jazz this year? I know somebody's going to comment down below and say they're hot garbage, because it's just always what people do, you know? And I want to hear, do you think you agree with me that I think they're going to have a lot more success this season in the postseason because they addressed their need to fix the perimeter D, which was, in my opinion, a big part of their problem, where Rudy Gobert kept getting exposed. It wasn't his fault at all, and it's nothing against him. It's just a lack of perimeter D. Now they can go with multiple guys, like I said earlier, by having lineups where Rudy Gay goes in there and is able to utilize his size with Royce O'Neal and Donovan Mitchell and Mike Conley. So with that being said, I want to hear your thoughts down below, guys, if you think that's the what they should do and if it's going to work, if it does happen. And yeah, I'm just gonna want to milk this video to 5 minutes. If you made it to the end of the video, thank you for that sweet, sweet ad revenue. Tell me down below, end of the video, gang, 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 buzz, 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 okay? If anyone gets that reference, King the Sting, great podcast. And look, guys, it's 12-12. Can we make 12-12 the new 11-11? Maybe. I have nothing else to say. It's 5 minutes of your time. It's been wasted on me. I hope you, it's not a waste. I hope I gave you some sort of value, okay? I hope in my heart, I believe I'm giving you knowledge of a team that's not discussed regularly or enough. And I think that is astounding because it's honestly a detriment to the league because we need to be talking about every team. But I'm done. Have a great day.